sorry about that. Welcome back to Morning Express. Sarima is falling off my jokes.
You're not funny. I'm even falling down. Okay. Now that you guys have had your laugh. So lined up for you, we have the entertainment stories now. Mm-hmm. Sophia, let's kick off with Dilish.
Right.
So yesterday we touched on that topic.
Right.
And by then everyone thought that was not her dad.
Yeah.
But now it's official, that's her father.
Yeah, her mother confirmed. They did this Skype thing.
Yes.
And she was asking him questions to confirm if he's the one. And when he answered right, she was screaming, yeah!
I thought it was kind of cute. There was a lot of flirting going on between the dad and the mom.
And he's supposed to go to Namibia to visit. So that's but Dilish wasn't there. Dilish wasn't there. So that was also very interesting, whether she's with her mom on this one or not. But you'll be telling us about that later.
Yes.
It's time to look at what we have for you today in our Know Kenya segment. And it is one of Kenya's great unknown treasures. It lies in the depths of the great Arabuko Sokoke Forest in Malindi. It is also an archaeological puzzle. Today on our Know Kenya segment, we feature the Gedi Ruins.
The name Gedi, or more properly Gede, is a Gala word meaning precious and is also used as a personal name. It is either the Gala name for the town which they destroyed or the name of the last Gala leader to camp on the site. The true name may be Kilimani, the quellman of the Bartholet map of 1639. In spite of extensive research, the history of Gedi and his people still remains an archaeological mystery. Once a great civilization with a population of over 2,500 inhabitants, this complex Swahili settlement was built during the 13th century. The Gedi ruins include elaborate houses, mosques, tombs, and cemeteries. Strangely though, Gedi doesn't seem to be mentioned in any historic writings or local recorded history, which has baffled historians, as Gedi was a relatively complex civilization spanning a 45-acre settlement.
This place, as you can see, I told you this is an audience room. So a back bench was meant for the leader. He could face everybody.
Yeah.
And this bench here was meant for his counselors, so that they could advise him either secretly or loud. Mm-hmm. And of course, the sunken court was meant for the public.
There seems to have been no contact with the nearby settlement at Malindi. One of Gede's greatest mysteries, however, is why the inhabitants of this interesting settlement suddenly abandoned it in the 17th century, leaving it in ruin. With no signs of battle, plague, disturbance, or any cause for this sudden desertion, this strange mystery is what visitors may ponder as they take a look around this mysterious ghost town in the indigenous jungles of East Africa.
For us as Kenyans to maintain our cultural aspects effectively, we need to visit places where cultural aspects are shown clearly and they could be felt by our fellow Kenyans. And a good example is for one to come to this place here. This Gede, Gede is a Swahili town, as I mentioned earlier. So for any one of us Kenyans who would like to know more about the Swahilis, please, the door is very much wide open for you to come and see for yourselves. Get hold of the Swahili artifacts that they were using. We have a lot of interactive programs around here. Please come and see for yourselves. Rather than Waswahili wanasema, shani ni ya kujionea, sio habari ya kusifiwa. Usiongojee kusifiwa, kwa hivyo njoo jionee mwenyewe mambo gani yako Gedi.
Hidden under thick layers of ancient rainforest, local folklore has in the past regarded Gede as a place of sinister spirits. After several hundred years, this secret hidden city began to be uncovered by archaeologists in the 20th century. It was gazetted in 1948.